people at our age are very hot-headed and just jump right into their first reaction. So especially with Ryan Sorba, people didn't stop to think about what the right mature decision is to make. And I chose just not to be a part of it. I think for the most part, I've just chosen not to be a part of events on campus where people are trying to protest something, but I just don't feel like they're doing it in the smartest of ways. And I suppose I'm not really doing anything by doing nothing. However, I, for myself, have just chosen not to participate in not well thought out plans, such as crawling through windows. Not my style.
I also didn't really agree with the way that the protest ended up. I think there was a censorship of free speech.
But you can't let people get away with that. I mean, yeah, there's such a thing as free speech, but you have to open your mouth.
It was actually the most exciting, most intense feeling of queer community that I've ever felt on this campus. And I know that there's a lot of controversy around how it was done, but for me personally, I felt like all of that social stuff that goes on was gone, and that people were really genuinely just fighting back and excited. And they were, you know, people were starting talking about, you know, you in this corner, you talk about how the administration treats queer people, and you in this corner sing songs, and you guys make out. So it was like a very, it was productive.
I don't know. I'm glad it wasn't violent or anything, right? It was, so that's good. At least we remained ladies.
My name is Anna Abbasi. I'm a junior here at Smith College. I'm from Detroit, Michigan. And I live in Gillette House, and I'm a film studies major.
Particularly for the Muslim cause, I wish there was a chaplain to kind of be the liaison between the students' needs and between the faculty needs. And
as a Latina, as somebody from Texas, used to seeing Hispanic people in leadership positions, I would love to see a Latina administrator on campus because we don't have one.
And I would want to change the admissions policies for transgender people. There is no admissions policy.
The only thing I would really want to change about Smith is maybe the upkeep of some of the buildings isn't as fabulous as it deserves to be.
When it comes to showing, for example, my knowledge of a certain philosopher or what I think on a certain issue, I don't see why it's necessary for me to write 8 pages on it when I could maybe create a project instead that would be much more meaningful, not only to me, but maybe to the community around me. So that's what I would change. I would just give a wider range of options for students to express their knowledge.
Maybe make people a little more open to new things.
But the student body, I would get rid of any feeling of social hierarchy, and I would make a more activist community.
For next year, they're changing the policy where if you want to work in the campus center, you can't be a Hans or an HP or hold like other house elected positions or anything that has to go through training at the beginning of the year. And that's a big problem for me, because I wanted to be House President for next year, but I also want to be a Campus Center Manager. And I have a really good chance of being a manager, and I also have a really good chance of being the House President. It also bothers me because it's also very classist. And I'm going to be using this big word, classist, because students who need the money that the Campus Center positions provide are not going to be able to be active members of their house in this way. And I think that that's a really big problem, because students like me who need money and who need to be working while they're here are not going to have these leadership opportunities, especially if they want them. And I think that that is very unfair, and I think it's classist. Because if you need money, you can't participate the same way that somebody who doesn't need that money can.
The Ada Lounge stinks like mold. I would replace the carpet, which, and get the leaks fixed in the windows.
There has to be some sort of memory so that people know that this is not the first occurrence, and so that they can kind of really push for institutional changes.
If I could change the administration, I would, just because of my personal experience, I would make them more honest about what the community really is like here.
I'd really like them to be more proactive. I'd like them to take a stronger stance. You know, after the blackface incident last year, the administration was like, "Oh, like we're gonna be more proactive. We're gonna be proactive against this, that, and the other." But it's like that whole proactive spirit has like faded, and now you just see the commercials on TV for like acne treatment.
Compared to a lot of other schools, the administration is very receptive to student concerns, at least in terms of hearing them. But I would say that, and this is probably an issue with, you know, be it faculty concerns, staff concerns, student concerns, I think the bureaucracy gets in the way quite a bit, and you don't necessarily see results for 2 or 3 years down the road.
At any college, there are things that you're not going to like. You're never going to find, you know, a place that's 100% absolutely what you want. And I think the best thing is to find ways to work with that, because that's part of the world, and the, you know, real life isn't, you know, terrific all the time. So.
My name is Sumo Momin. I'm a class of 2011. I'm an economics major, and I'm the HCA of Justin House.
My name is Kai Marcus Devlin. I'm a junior, sociology, study women and gender, double major. I'm originally from Long Island, and I live in Talbot House.
I will remember Smith as 4 hellish years.
I remember my friends, I'll remember a couple of my classes.
But really 4 years of like a lot of good people in my life, people I would have never met anywhere else.
A place I think that I've learned very, very much about, more about life than anything else, I think.
4 years of really interesting classes.
I think I will remember it as a place that really fostered growth for me, really personal growth and finding out who I am.
4 years with a couple of failed classes.
I think I'll remember Smith as a place where I was given a lot of flexibility and room to develop into who I am now.
4 years of maybe a GPA that is not awesome on paper, but I feel like I really worked my ass off for. And just 4 years of like a lot of experience, a lot of life lessons, a lot of people that I can call, that I can like count on. And just, it was a good 4 years.
So, and I'll remember how cold it is.
Really fondly. With a lot of excitement, a lot of happiness, and a lot of contentment. I feel very content with my experience here. And I don't think I'll ever look back on it with anger or with dismay or regret. I think it's great. I'm so glad I chose to come here.
I will remember it as the best 4 years of my life. This is the greatest gay buffet, I like to call it the gay buffet, ever. You just don't get places like this every day. You can move to P-Town, you can move to West Hollywood, move wherever you want. You're never going to find another Smith College. This place is one of a kind. It really is. I have no regrets about coming here.
I will remember Smith as a place that I learned a lot and that I had a lot of fun here. I love Smith parties. I love my classes. And I am very proud to go to Smith.